XJS, Jaguar's E-Type Sports Replacement. Actually, the first really new Jaguar sports car since 1961. 150 miles an hour of British Jaguar. Sports car? Today? Well, perhaps the much misused Grand Tour would really be more appropriate. The XJS represents the last car with which Sir William Lyons was associated. So far, it's cost Leyland £6.5 million for development and setting up production. But over the next year, they hope to recoup more than £26 million in exports to North America alone. Surprisingly, those very complicated-looking all-quartz halogen headlamps from Sibi had to come from France, although at least Lucas do supply the electronically controlled fuel injection on the world's largest production V12, all 5.3 litres of it. 15 miles to the gallon. That's if you're a good driver, of course. Inside, in addition to the usual Jaguar dials, there are no less than 18 warning lights. The dash electrics, they are printed circuit. The controls illuminated by fibre optics. They call it the 2 plus 2, but what 2 you're going to put in the back, I don't know, because we don't rate the rear seat accommodation in either legroom or headroom. Performance, 0 to 60 in 6.8 seconds. Well, it doesn't feel that quick. If you went for a 3-speed automatic, then in drive, the up changes occur at a surprisingly docile 4,000 RPM. But perhaps its most staggering virtue is the silence on the move. It really is uncannily quiet. How much would it cost you? £8,900. Now that sounds a lot, doesn't it? Especially for a Jag. But when you consider the price of its opponents, like Porsche and the Mercedes 450 SLC at £11,500, well, this is almost a bargain. A future export winner? Well, a present-day classic, that's for sure. But in these austere times, this star of Earl's Court in the mid-70s could well be the last new Jaguar.